Hey Pixels! In this week's tutorial, I'll be showing you how to create this super trendy knockout text effect with CSS3. Step aside Photoshop, we can now create a text clipping mask right in our web browsers with a little bit of code, HTML5 and CSS3 code. This cool knockout text effect will look awesome on any website. It's also completely responsive. In this tutorial, I'm going to be coding these two large hero text effects for the Six God himself, Drake. Be sure to visit my blog, xopixel.com, for more information on the CSS properties and access to the source files used in this tutorial. So, without any further delay, let's code. First, we're going to write some really simple code between the body tags. Let's code two headings using the h1 tag. The first h1 tag will have the class knockoutText1, and the second h1 tag will have the class knockoutText2. We're also going to write Drake in capital letters within the h1 tags. That way, we'll be able to show a good amount of the image through the text. That's all for the HTML. Now, let's head on over to the CSS. First, we're going to apply our quick CSS reset by setting our margin and padding to 0. Then, we're going to turn the background of our page black using the 000 hex color code. Then, we're going to set the margin and padding of our H1 tag to 0 as well. We're going to select our first knockout text and set its fallback color to white. Then, we're going to set the font family of the text to Oswald, which is a Google font. If you would like to know how to add Google fonts to your website, check out my article in the description box below. Now, we're going to use the background property to add the image that we'll be using in our text. I'm going to be using an image from Drake's latest album, Views. We also don't want the image to repeat, so we'll be using the no repeat value. Then, we're going to use the background size cover declaration so that the image fills the entire width of the element. Now, this is where the magic happens. We're first going to use the property WebKit Text Fill Color and set its value to transparent. That way, the background image that we specified above can show through the text. Then, we're going to use the WebKit Background Clip property and set its value to text. That means that the background that we set above will only be shown in the H1 text. Lastly, we're going to set the size of the text to 28VW, which means that the font is 28% of the viewport's width, and we're also going to center the text. Not only did we make a cool knockout text effect with CSS3, but we also made it completely responsive. But there's still one more thing I want to show you. I also want to show you how to take this knockout text effect one step further by adding an animation. It's super easy to do this, and it's going to take you 10 seconds. I'm just going to copy the code from the first knockout text heading and paste it below. Then, I'm just going to change its class to our second H1 tag class called knockoutText2. Then I'm going to change the background image from drake.jpg into drake.gif. We just added a GIF to give the knockout text a cool animation. I told you it was easy. So there you have it. You've just coded a super trendy knockout text effect with CSS3. Give this video a big thumbs up if you liked it. Subscribe to XOPixel for more great coding tutorials just like this one. As always, thank you for watching. I will see you in next week's video.